the developing story tonight as the state braces for Tropical Storm Debby. We also want you to know about our Hurricane Central app. It's been upgraded. So if you have your smartphone, make sure you have our upgraded app and also know that the threat level has been up to 3. So if you're following along, if it ups more or is downgraded, you'll know, right?
Exactly. And the whole idea with bringing it up to 3 is that we want people to be ready. We want them to know that there is a storm in the Gulf, that it's actually moving our way. There is a tropical storm warning posted, but what people don't realize is that it is forecast to actually move north and then turn west. But I got to tell you, Charlie was forecast to move to the north and then move over towards Tampa. It didn't do it. So whenever you have a system moving parallel to the coast, as this is forecast to do, you really need to pay attention. So here is a look at Debby. And you know, Debby really doesn't look like much right now. All of that rain is on the east side, but Debby has broken a record. Back in 2005, we got our fourth tropical storm in July. It was Dennis. We now have broken that record with Debby developing in June, the fourth storm, and it is likely to become a hurricane. That's what the Hurricane Center is now saying. The big problem that Debby has is that there is all of this wind shear. Can you see the upper level low over the western portion of the Gulf? And it's causing this wind shear that's moving right over Debby. And let me tell you, tropical systems do not like wind shear. But it's fascinating to look at these models. Here is a look at the global forecast model. It is now slowly moving Debby over towards Florida. This is the GFS. It's one of the best models there is, and it's just been consistent on taking it to the northeast. Meanwhile, another one of our models, which is a very good model, takes it to the north, northeast, the rain bands right along the coast of Florida, and then it has it begin to move to the west. Now, this is just updated, and it is a little bit more to the northeast. And people have been saying, why, if we have a tropical storm warning, isn't our rain chance higher? Well, you can see how that rain really gets wrapped around the system. Cold front drops to the south, and then it slowly begins to sink to the south, eventually to the west. Here is a look at our European model, and it consistently has taken the system to the west, and now it's forecasting it to be a hurricane. In fact, we can go to our exact live radar. This is what I want you to see. These are the isobars, and they basically show the motion of the wind. And what they're showing you is that we are going to have this water piling up along our coast. And because of that, we do have those storm warnings posted. And I tell you, Patrick Crawford has been watching this all day. Patrick, what do you see for rain and wind and for tides?
Well, Margaret, some areas the rain is going to be much heavier. The winds will be much stronger. The one area that we aren't seeing a big chance for heavy rainfall is along the North Shore. We're looking at Tangipahoa Parish, Washington Parish, also St. Tammany Parish. Rainfall estimates anywhere from 1.5 to 1.5 inches overall. Winds gusting anywhere from 15 to 25 miles per hour. But as we head further east, the Mississippi Gulf Coast, also down towards Lake Bourne, you can see heavier rainfall will be possible, 2 to 4 inches, stronger winds at 25 to 35 miles per hour, maybe even some gusts over 45 miles per hour. But the big focus, kind of the area that we're really watching very, very closely, is along the south part of the viewing area. We're looking at the South Shore, and you can see along the Louisiana coast, we are expecting anywhere from 3 to 6 inches of rainfall, damaging winds, and that storm surge 1 to 3 feet above normal will be possible. Timing wise, Sunday night, you're going to start to see those, feel those easterly winds at around 20 to 25 knots, stronger for Monday. As we look at your planner for Sunday, a 20% chance for a shower. So if you're worried about things starting to pick up tomorrow, just the wind speeds will be picking up. Temperatures tomorrow afternoon, they look like they're going to be very hot. It's also going to be very humid, and we're not done with the heat just yet. Here's a look at that detailed 7-day exact cast. Temperatures will continue to rise throughout the week. We could be dealing with a heat advisory for the area by Friday. So we're also talking about the tropics tonight, but we want to give you an update that we could have some dangerous heat on the way later this week. And the big question mark will be the track of Tropical Storm Debby. Margaret, if it's a little further south, maybe the impact not as big, but if it goes a little further north, then maybe most of the area could be dealing with some of the effects.
Well, that's true. And real quickly, I want you to look at our exact live radar. We, of course, have the track up, and I want you to see that there is the potential that we could have a hurricane south of Marsh Island, and that would indeed be for Tuesday. How about that?
Absolutely. That's something that we're going to have to watch very closely. And with the models kind of being very inconsistent, it's just something we have to keep on looking
really
at and be
ready. Have to pay attention because it could shift, and we don't want you to be caught unaware.
Absolutely.
Rachel.
Thank you, Margaret.